Just do it. It's gonna help you in the long run. That one is the truth. Starts off running. All right, and girl, let me just tell you. It's not a game, it's a rage thing. Welcome back to the Nursing Diary. My name is Sierra. For those of you who don't already know, I make content related to nursing, lifestyle, and beauty. And today's video is going to be about the do's and don'ts of nursing school. About a week ago, I did a poll on Instagram about what content y'all want to see, and y'all spoke. Y'all said y'all want to see more nursing content. So today I'm going to be doing the do's and don'ts of nursing school. So without further ado, let's just hurry up and get into the video. We're going to start off with the do's. The first do that I have is to do more to manage your time. Nursing school is so time consuming, and if you're working, if you have family, if you have friends, you really kind of have to learn how to manage all of that in the best manner to where you're not too overly stressed or overworked. At the end of the day, you're going to be overstressed and overworked with nursing school, but managing your time will help you so much. So if you need to get a planner, do that. If you need to write down things on your to-do list, do that. Those are things that personally help me. I always get a planner, which helps me manage my time. I get an appointment book, which literally marks out the 12 hours in the day. That's what I like to do to manage my time, and I like to stick to it. It's important that you stick to it so that you get everything done. There's only so many hours in the day, but there's so many assignments, so many things to read, so much to do, clinicals and all that stuff. So just make sure that you manage your time. The second do that I have for the do's and don'ts of nursing school is do more to be prepared before class. If you have 5 chapters to read, or if this certain lecture that you're going to go over is going to be over respiratory, make sure that you read over respiratory before class. Many of my professors, they went over the basics, they went through, or sometimes they even did class activities where they expected you to already know the material before you got to class. And when you get to class, you're expected to ask questions, you're expected to ask for clarification. So it does you a favor if you read ahead of time, if you take notes, and also if you highlight the things that you read maybe in the book or whatever they told you to read, and then you go back and you highlight the things that they mention in class. Usually then you know that that's going to be on the exam, or that's something important that you need to know. So make sure that you do more to prepare for class and be prepared. Just be prepared. Just do it. It's going to help you in the long run. The third do that I have on my do's and don'ts is to utilize YouTube, other study tools. YouTube is literally my holy grail. I have literally used YouTube for things that I don't understand, whether it's pharmacology, whether it's med surg, whether it's maternal health. I literally use YouTube for everything. It's so helpful. Sometimes the professors or the book might not make sense the way you need to. If you're a visual learner, there's lots on YouTube that shows visuals. If you're just like a reading person, I don't know, read the book. But if you need more to teach you or more to show you what's going on about this particular content, use YouTube. And there's so many mnemonics that they use and so many things that just makes it so much easier to know. So the main YouTube channels that I like to use is Registered Nurse RN. We freaking love Sarah. We freaking love her. She's literally everybody's professor. Level Up RN. I love her because she keeps everything so simple. Her videos are only like 6 to 10 minutes long. So quick, so easy. And she also has flashcards that you can follow along with if you're interested in that. And then also Simple Nursing. Simple Nursing is really cool. He uses a lot of mnemonics and his voice is just really, I don't know, it's something that you can't forget. So those are my top three. And if you guys also know other nursing channels that can help other students, comment them down below. All right, those were my top three do's. Now I'm gonna go over my top three don'ts. You do not wanna do these things in nursing school. Don't do it. I'm trying to save you. Okay, here we go. We're gonna start with the first don't. Don't wait till last minute to study. I'm just gonna tell you now. Nursing school, there is so much content. There's so much to know. Do not wait till the last minute to study. And when you're prepared and you know the content ahead of time, you won't be wasting last minute to study. So when you get behind, it's really hard to catch back up. So stay on top of your game. Don't wait last minute to study. I'm gonna say it again. Don't wait last minute to study, okay? Okay. The second don't that I have on my do's and don'ts is do not slack during your clinical rotations. Literally, clinicals is like the best part of nursing school. I don't know Others may disagree, but I love clinicals. And there are some people who literally get to clinical and they're like, no, I'll just let the nurse do it, or I'll just watch, or they don't do anything during clinicals. This is literally your time to practice for when you become a nurse. There's so many new grad nurses that have maybe never done NG tubes, that have maybe never done a catheter. There are so many things that you might not get to do. So when you have the opportunity to do it, then you need to do it. Literally this last following semester, I only got to insert one IV, and it was only because my nurse let me do it on him. I never had the chance to do it on a patient. Either they had already been done, either the IV was just too hard and the nurse couldn't even get it, so they didn't let me do it. But there was just so many other things that went into play to where I didn't get the opportunity to do an IV. And I also made that be known to my nurses. Hey, one thing I really want to do today is an IV. So if you let them know that, they'll try to get you the opportunity. So when you get the opportunity, just do it. If you're nervous, you can say, hey, I'm really nervous for this. Do you mind walking me through it? I do that all the time. I just say, I remember how to do this, but do you mind walking me through it while I do it and just giving me notes or tips and things like that? Because sometimes they expect you to already know how to do it. Like, we're not nurses. We're still students. We're still learning. So don't be afraid to ask for help. But when you get the opportunity, just do it. Do not slack off in at clinicals. This is all for your learning. And then make sure you're always an advocate for yourself. Third don't that I have on my do's and don'ts is do not add parts or eliminate parts to a question. You want to make sure that you know exactly what the question is asking. Don't add things or take things away from the question. You want to read them slow, and you want to make sure that you understand every single bit of the question. Literally take what the question is giving you and do process of elimination while you're taking your exams. I don't really know if that third don't made sense, but I hope it did to some of y'all. Now I'm going to go over some of the other do's and don'ts that nursing students have shared with y'all for me to share with you pre-nursing students, and hopefully this will help out some nursing students that are already in the nursing program or pre-nursing students that are about to start nursing school. I really do hope that these are helpful for you. Do practice questions for your exams. Manage your funds. Make sure you have a low stress job if that's possible for you. Make sure you ask so many questions. Try to read over materials before class if possible so that you can better understand things in class. Do get a foldable clipboard, a planner, and a drug book. I definitely stand by that. We have someone who said do have fun. Definitely have fun. Nursing school can be very stressful, but it also can be very fun in some aspects. Do take initiative during clinicals. Don't just say, I'll watch. Be open and try to practice everything at clinicals. Do make friends. I'm gonna say I love this one because I love my nursing school friends. Honestly, at first when I started nursing school, it was kind of hard for me to form new bonds or whatever, but once I got active on campus and joining organizations and things like that and stepping out of my comfort zone, I have learned that nursing school and my support of my nursing school friends is the best thing that I could have ever done, and it's literally so great. So make sure you find some nursing school friends. They understand what you're going through more than anyone else, so find some friends. You won't regret it. And then someone also said, be prepared with your materials 2 weeks before the deadline. Make sure that it's complete. All right, so here are some of the don'ts that we have shared from some of our already nursing students. Someone said, don't wear acrylics. That is true. You can't have nails in nursing school. I always get my nails after the semester, like literally as soon as the semester is done, I'm on my way to the nail shop. I like my nails being done, but obviously as a nurse, I won't be able to have nails, long nails. In some units, you can't even have nail polish. So don't wear acrylics, don't have nail polish, don't procrastinate. Girl, don't procrastinate. Like I said, don't wait till the last minute. You have to stay on top of your game, because if you wait, if you fall behind, it will be so hard to pick back up. Someone said, don't overwhelm yourself with all the due dates in the beginning. It gets very, very stressful, and literally nursing school starts off running. So make sure you take it one day at a time, 1 week at a time, and you will finish before you know it. Someone said, don't neglect pharmacology. Go over it every single day. And this is definitely, I agree with it, because pharmacology will follow you literally throughout the rest of your nursing career and throughout the rest of nursing school. So make sure you stay on top of your pharmacology. Someone also said, don't spend your entire life studying. Get out and take a break. I definitely agree with this. Don't forget about your self-care. Don't forget to take a break. Literally don't let nursing school consume your life, because if you get stressed, if you get overwhelmed, we know that that kind of stress can also cause you to be very tired and can also cause you to get sick. So still prioritize your health, still prioritize your family and your friends in the best manner that you can with still managing nursing school. If you learn how to manage all those things in a good time manner, you will still be able to focus on school, get good rest, and also spend time with your family and friends. Someone said, don't stress about grades. No one cares about your GPA when you get a job. And girl, let me just tell you, that one is the truth. That one is the truth. Before I started nursing school, I had A's and I had B's, and it was great. Everything was wonderful, and that's why I was able to get into the nursing program. But once I got into the program, all of that stuff changed. I wasn't an A student. I literally didn't get A's until my second semester of nursing school once I figured out how to manage all of it. But literally, like, y'all, it's okay though. And I had to tell myself that at the end of the day, I still get to be a nurse as long as I graduate, as long as I pass my NCLEX, I'm still gonna be a nurse. Regardless of if I get a C in all of my nursing classes, that doesn't determine what kind of nurse I'm gonna be. That doesn't determine whether I'm gonna be able to care for my patients in the same manner as those who maybe got all A's. It doesn't determine that. It just determines that, yeah, maybe you know your stuff on paper. That doesn't matter. At the end of the day, you all will graduate, you all will become a nurse. So don't let your grades define you. Don't let it define you. Don't let it define you. And one more time, don't let it define you. You are going to be a wonderful nurse regardless. Someone said, don't forget your ABCs, airway, breathing, circulation. Always prioritize these when you're taking your exams. Literally say, okay, does my patient have a patent airway? Hey, is my patient breathing? Does my patient have good circulation? Always prioritize those three to help you get through any of your med surge questions or any question at all. It'll help you. Literally, don't forget it. And then the last one we have is don't take the last available T's. This one is for the pre-nursing students. If you're about to apply to nursing school, do not wait to take the very last T's test, because if you don't do well and you have to retake it, you have to wait until the very next cycle to get into the nursing program. So start off soon. Start studying as soon as you can. Take the test near the beginning, and if you realize that you have to take it again, take another one, not the last due date, because you might have to redo it again. So always prepare in advance. Make sure you're studying ahead of time so that you don't even have to go through that. But in case you do, always be prepared. Take the early test so that you have time to take another one. And that is it for this week's video. I hope that was helpful for you guys. If you guys enjoyed it, go ahead and give this video a thumbs up. If you didn't, give it a thumbs down. That's okay. I love your feedback. Go ahead and leave any comments that you liked about the do's, liked about the don'ts, or maybe, oh, what are your do's and don'ts? Comment them down below. I hope you guys, again, love this video. Don't forget to always be kind, love yourself and others, and always go out and try your best. I will see y'all in the next video. Bye! It's not a game, it's a ratchet.